Look, we've got a legend coming on. This is a big one. I don't know what's happening to our show because suddenly we've got two or three big names. We had Chunky Pandey. We've got another big name coming up. It's a bit of a surprise in case you haven't checked out our information desk, which is somewhere on the same podcast. Before I do that, I just a quick tip, another health tip for people out there who need hygiene and suffer from perspiration like I do. That's the entire opposition, people who attack the government and anybody else who feels like sweating all the time because of fear and anxiety. I've realized that पूरा दिन में ये पसीना चालू है एंड यू कैन हैंडल इट नॉट आई अंडरस्टैंड बट देयर इज वन सिंपल टेक्निक यू आर पुटिंग द डिओड्रेंट ऑन द स्किन इफ यू पुट द डिओड्रेंट हियर ऑन दिस वेट पैच दैट यू सी दैट्स डिओड्रेंट दैट्स नॉट स्वेट येट यू विल गेट अ मच बेटर रिलीज ऑफ स्मेल इट्स बेटर फॉर द पीपल इन द रूम आई हैव डन दिस एज एन एक्सपेरिमेंट आई प्रॉमिस यू हैंड ऑन हार्ट दैट दिस वर्क्स बेटर देन पुटिंग इट ऑन बेयर स्किन दिस इज माय लिटिल टिप फॉर द डे टू एवरीवन हु स्वेट्स अ लॉट एंड नाउ You'll be sweating more because I'm getting a big name on the show. Without using money or influence, we've been able to get him, the one and only Anu Malik. Anu, do I
Hi,
call you Anu G, Anu
I'm
Sir, Anu Saab, Malik Sir, Malik
excited.
Saab?
No, they don't have to call me Malik Saab. No, Anu Sir, nothing. Say Anu G if you want to. You can say even Anu. And by the way, when you said, "Arey, without using money or influence," भैया मैं जनता का सेवा करता हूँ. I love you, Cyrus. It's not about money always. It's about love, compassion, friendship, and making people happy out there.
Yeah, you know, Anu, actually, we go back a long way. I mean, you are always a big name since I can remember. We'll go and talk about all that. But I do remember MTV, we had some events, interviews with you also, but we had some events. You won't remember this, but there was one event you came to Tata Theatre in Nariman Point. I think
NCBA.
it was Lycra Awards, yeah, something like that.
Yeah, I remember. I remember.
And you
And
won the
Cyrus,
Kills Award.
I saw you there. I've seen you performing also. And Cyrus, it was love at first sight. And
Yeah.
when I say love at first sight, I love you. I love your talent. And I came up on the stage and I came up and personally came up to you and I said, I loved you in the show, Cyrus. And you just turned around and you were wearing a nice, beautiful suit. I think a black color suit or something. And you turned around and said, we exchanged numbers. And I said, Cyrus, I want to be in touch with you. Whenever you need me, I'll always be there for you. Because I love people who are talented and you're one of them.
Thank you, Anu. Thank you so much for that. But I actually was talking about a second thing. During the technical or just before the show started, you were going on stage to check the sound or check your moment and all that, the usual thing that happens. And then you came back to your car, which was parked out, and I passed you, and you said, "Come here." And I said, "Okay, come here. I want you to listen to this." And you took me into the car and you played this new track of yours for me. And we listened to it together. I came out of the car, I thought my life was made. I said, Anu Malik asked me for my opinion on his new track separately alone. This is one of my big stories at the bar that weekend.
You know why I did that, Cyrus? Because I know you're a man who keeps on, raising the bar of your life in terms of whatever you do. And I said, "Kya pata one day if Cyrus becomes a producer, he says, sign up Anu Malik, sign that kid up." You never know. हम तो अभी काम ढूंढते रहते हैं.
I'll sign Adar up, your nephew. I was locked in a room with him for 2 days doing a stupid
Did you
show on
congratulate
Amazon.
him? Did you congratulate him? He got married. He got
Huh?
married.
I just did
Yeah.
an event with him last week. He
He
didn't say
didn't tell
anything.
you. Yeah, I just congratulated him yesterday. He's a sweetheart.
What happened to the Punjabi bada dil log who, I mean, where's my invite? How can you not tell me?
He didn't tell me also. He didn't tell anyone. He just quietly, he's that sort of a guy, but we all congratulated him.
Oh, but he's a great guy. Congratulations, Adar, if you're there somewhere, God knows. That's fine. I love the guy. I got to tell you, Anu, he's just my type of guy. And we spent that whole show that we did Laugh Out Loud together. And the actual humor, I wish they would show what we were saying to each other, which of course was very far from the content they actually displayed. And he made me laugh so much, but I was able to keep my
But
head down.
I love this show because I loved you and other and everybody on it because you all had to stop yourself from laughing when someone was tickling your tickling you and trying to provoke you to laugh. And I love the way you kept a straight face. And I said to myself, Cyrus is dying to laugh, but he's not laughing.
No, him especially because he's got a poker face if ever you've seen one. I don't know
Yeah,
if he's one of the
he's
Malik
completely.
family's traits. The ability to not show any emotion and that very British sort of style of
Yeah, he's very
comedy.
different from us. एकदम अलग ही है वो
No wonder he got married on the sly, यार.
Yeah.
We have to check that out. Okay, but this is not his show. One day we'll do a show with him. We've actually done a show with him. Let's get to the one and only Anu Malik. I mean, boss, look at, I mean, where do we start? First and foremost, it's still at the top of the profession after so many years. How many people can say that? Even Roger Federer, I think this is the end of his reign. But still there, I'm talking from 80s, 90s, 2000, 2010, 2020. I mean, that's just unbelievable. But we have to go back and look at your life for a little while, if you don't mind, sir.
Sure.
So let's, at the age of seven, you was like a prodigy. You could create tunes with words, everything. So can you, do you have any recollection of all that? And all these big names around you, like Sahil Ludhiawani, Raj Kapoor, Raja Mehdi Ali Khan Saab.
You know, okay. So what is, let's take a step back and understand the question. Age 7 years. I'm born to, I always say my father's still alive, though he's no more with us. It is my father, Shri Sardar Malik Saab, on whose house I was born. And as a child, I remembered dad, you know, always, I mean, I heard musical sounds in the house. And I used to always wonder what's up. And I realized that there are producers coming or daddy's just making tunes. And that maybe came into my DNA. So when I was schooling, I remember I was six at that time, six. I was told to learn a poem, a Marathi poem, you know. And I couldn't get the hang of the words. So what I did was I took the words and I started, Yere Yere Pausa. You know, there was a song, there was a poem, Yere Yere Pausa. So I started humming a tune on it. I didn't know what I was doing, just to make it easy for me to understand the words. I don't know what I hummed. And I came home humming the tune. So dad found me humming and said, what are you doing? I said, I'm making this poetry easier. He said, have you made the tune? I said, yes. So he put some words in front of me. Okay, if you say you made a tune, but dad was curious. So he said, why don't you, in front of me right now, start humming something on these words. So that was my first induction into music. And I didn't know that, but dad was doing that for me. So I took those piece of words. I mean, I think, I don't know what he wrote, something. And I started humming a tune. And suddenly, dad came and hugged me. And the first word he said, you know, I don't know, it's amazing. I get very emotional. He said, Hari, my Mozart, you just made a tune in front of me. So what happens to me, Cyrus, is if you give me words right now to make that scene come alive, you can just give me any few words and a tune flows out. This is where Saraswati Ma's blessings come in. I don't plan that tune. Sometimes it may be beautiful. Sometimes it may not work for you. I may say it's not working. But a tune flows out on the words. You give me any word and the tune flows out.
Can I do it?
Sure.
Right now. Okay, guys, this is live.
Because this is live and nobody knows. We haven't planned it. We don't know anything. You don't know. I didn't know you want to ask me this question.
No setup. Yeah, Everybody knows. One thing we are is honest. It may be a horrible show, but we are always honest. Okay.
No, so this is the best show. Don't call it a horrible show. I'm on it, bro.
This episode is superb. And Chunky. Chunky was great. Okay.
Even the show is going to be great. Even Chunky, I love very much. Chunky Pandey is also a sweetheart. He's a good friend.
Well, two of you, what I really like, there is a little similarity, of course, in the sense that I just love stories of people who just carry on. You know, it's just amazing. People otherwise have a peak and they disappear. But there's a few people in all the art forms of the world, but not too many, just a few people like yourself who can just sort of, from beginning to end, they stay on. You got to study them more because there must be something in you guys. This is not just about talent. The ability to survive, you know, that's another thing altogether.
As far as I'm concerned, it's been tough because I grew up in a tough neighborhood, a lot of... I've seen a lot of pain. So, but everyone has a backstory. You may have a backstory. So, I don't want to go into that backstory. But
she's in the next room.
Huh?
Right there. And she took your photographs back in the late 90s also.
Oh,
and,
yeah, I remember.
To your house. Her name is Aisha. Yep. My also have to check. Likha is me.
My regards and respects to her.
Yeah. But listen, before we get to bad story, I want to do this test now once. Because we said, no, we have to do it.
I like the word test. I love the word test. Test. Mere zindagi mein yehi hua.
Okay, test me.
People have been putting me in front of, you know, exam. Take an examination of this guy. Find out if he's really talented. It's good. It's fun. Let's go for it.
And it's so much the reverse of other musicians who can come onto a show or TV program, whatever, and they don't want to perform. They're just almost shy or like reserved. Or I mean, it's so nice and refreshing to have. This is why I like the performer who performs. So ready?
Give me the
How many words do I give you? Ek, do, teen, char?
Whatever.
Okay. COVID vaccine. Third wave. Maharashtra or Mumbai?
Now, see, when you said Maharashtra, I suddenly thought, so this tempo came into my mind. I don't know why, because everyone in Maharashtra loves to groove and dance. So I got a 6-8 tempo in my head. COVID vaccine. What are the other words? COVID vaccine?
third wave.
COVID vaccine, third wave, Maharashtra, nahi aayega yaha kuch bhi tension, aao kar lo Maharashtra ki yatra. COVID vaccine, third wave, Maharashtra, nahi aayega yaha koi bhi tension, aao karo Maharashtra ki yatra. So now if you take out these words, it becomes a great song. You put brass on.
So this copyright is mine or yours?
Then you put a guitar. So you can. This is the. I just made a song for you.
It's fantastic. Again, I'm asking, is the copyright yours or mine? That's my only question.
It should be asked. Dono share kar lenge.
50-50?
50-50. Chal. Done.
Oh, yeah. Kavada, 50-50. The Anu Malik, live, exclusive, and without any instrumentation. What's it called back in the MTV days? You used to have unplugged. Unplugged.
Totally unplugged.
Superb. Now,
I made a song right in front of you. And if you have a great writer coming and writing something, we could have some beautiful words and it could turn out to be a great song with great, brass sections and rhythm and guitars coming in and a lot of harmonies coming in. Once the production is inside, I mean, you can sit on a logic and come out with it. It'll be fabulous.
Which it reminds me during lockdown, because you're famous for this ensemble and getting all what you described just now. So how are you coping then? How would you get
it? It's not an easy. So what I like, I just completed the Hangama score, Hangama 2 pitches that came out. And that one particular number has done very, very well. I had to redo the whole number. Shura ke dil mera, which was pictured as Shilpa Shetty. So I took Benny Dayal to sing the song with my daughter Anmol. So we worked at home and I made the entire antaras and gave it to my sound producer. Then he sent it. There were a lot of to and fro going. And then suddenly one day we had to put a lot of masks and go into a studio to get the brass section of the guitars. But we managed.
Yeah, but people don't understand how difficult it is for musicians because you're trying to get all these people together and you can't get them.
No, it was very tough. It was excruciatingly tough because we had to get permissions. The studios were not opening up. We had to show them, RT-PCR test negative reports, and then oximeters were checked. And everything was happening. The fever was checked and then they were allowed to enter. We were allowed to enter. It was scary, but we managed.
Yeah, well, c'est la vie, as they say in Maharashtra state. It's a new language. Anu, I want to ask you, but when you were in college, firstly, I understood one thing. The Marathi song that upset you in the beginning almost was a catalyst for you to become a musician, in a sense. It's such a very young
age. It didn't upset me. I love Marathi culture. I love Marathi poetry. I love being born in Maharashtra. You know, it's something which I know I can understand Marathi very, very well.
Middle class Mumbaiker who is not Maharashtrian, not speaking the language fluently like all of us. I used to just copy the whole thing in Hindi. And music
I remember to make things easier, I do that even now, because if I find something very difficult, I start humming. If I find a situation very stressful in my life, I start humming songs. I remember, you'll be surprised, when I was not well and I was going through a lot of pain, I was in the car and my wife said, you know what you were doing, you were in acute pain, you were humming a song. So it's something that I can't imagine, but I think somehow music does lower the stress levels to a point. You know, and for me, I just hum tunes. I keep on humming songs all the time.
But there will be places where that won't be welcome. For example, if you're at a funeral and you're not feeling good about being there or whatever, you're feeling sad.
When I go to a funeral, I do keep quiet. But then there's something, a sad note comes in my heart. So I'm not hurrying it. But there is a sad wail of a violin. But it's something that,
it's not disrespectful, it's just your heart is flowing.
No, but I wouldn't hum there in a funeral. I just keep quiet. In fact, tears do flow out. But there is tune all around me. There's music all around me. And for me, music is my life, my soul, my very existence. And people take it otherwise. Sometimes people laugh at me. I've noticed that people have also wondered what kind of a person is Anu Malik, who takes a producer, goes to his car and starts humming a tune. But I can't restrain myself. For me, to hum a tune is my God. You know, people said, why do you ask work? You don't. One of my very good producers said, you know, Anu Malik, you're a legend. You've done so much work. But we see the hunger in you even today like a child. I think that keeps me going. For example, if Cyrus Brocha was to announce, I'm going to start a new film tomorrow, I'll be the first one calling you up and saying, Cyrus, I've got a tune for you. So, you know, it's something, maybe it's something to do with my background. Maybe my father didn't have a lot of work and maybe I was hungry for work. Or maybe I wanted to show the world I'm talented. So I've taken my bouquets and my brickbats and here I am.
So there's a theory that there's the people with the fake ego who just want to be famous and validated by others. And there's people with the real ego. You know, and again, I'm coming back to how you survive 40, 50 years. So people with the real ego, that ego is about proving to yourself that you're good enough, that you're still the best. You know, like say a Sachin Tendulkar going on batting or an Anu Malik going on playing. Is it possible that at the end of the day, you actually, actually it's cliche, but competing with yourself is that you get up and say, I can still do this. I can, you know, I've still got it in me. And
no, so there's a lovely question you asked, Iris, and I really love this question. But let me flip this around. For me, it's not about me. For me, it's not about me proving that I'm the best. For me, this is a little emotional. But I see a lot of pain around me. When I was shooting yesterday, and I came back, I told my wife, you know, when my car goes, when I see a lot of people on the roads in pain, totally, you know, I find deprived souls. I first thank God for what he or she has given me. After that, I feel I owe a lot to these people to make them happy. When I'm on television, and you notice that, I like to bring a shayari, I'll do masti, I'll sing and dance. Because I think at the end of the day, an auto rickshaw driver, or a carpenter, or an engineer, or someone who's been working very hard the whole day in the office, comes back home, switches on his television. He wants to be happy for those 2 hours. I do that through my music also. I'll make a song that makes you happy, not sad. Until the situation is very tough. But I'm not proving it to myself. I'm here because God has given me talent. And as long as I live, I want to make people happy. That's the way I get up in the morning. And also, yes, I also find out that others have done a lot of great work. So I always compare. I say, Abhidhak, I have not reached that position where a Panchayat has reached. I feel I could do better. I could do better. I could do better. So that feeling of I could do better provokes me and motivates me to come up and start working. And then the feeling of tiredness never comes. Why should I be tired? This gift is a gift from the gods. I'm going to use it as long as I can.
Yeah, I mean, I wonder, I'm still trying to figure out what the formula is for people like you, you know, that special group that keep going and getting better at the art form. It's not like they just keep going. You're actually able to reinvent yourself. I mean, talk about your television career, for example, you know, I mean, that's a whole different you. There's the composer. Of course, it's all you in, at the end of the day, and you've got a certain flamboyance. We accept that. But a lot of tarif here, a lot of praise. I think you're just a huge role model for a lot of people. Just the longevity with the talent, which cannot be a small thing. And I'm not saying that it's easy to have talent for even 5 years. I know a lot of people have, that is also a great thing to have done and be a superstar for 5 years. But to endure is something fantastic. I really believe it comes from inside.
It comes from inside, Cyrus. And I mentioned Sachin Tendulkar. I mean, today also, I mean, he's retired. But today, if you set him out of the field, I'm sure he'll slam a century, even today. You know?
Yes.
So some people are born with it. I don't know whether I'm born with it, but I strive to be better all the time. I strive. I when I look at you, your weekend show, I never miss. And I always laugh with you and, you know, when Kunal and you are there, it's a laugh riot. So for me, I don't know how you'll come up with these ideas. And I feel I take inspiration from people like you. That these guys are working day in and day out. So I'm not the only guy who's working. There are everyone working. But I want to make life easy for a lot of people. I do go through pain. I'm human. And there are times when I'm down and out. But I provoke myself to get up. And there are a lot of inspirations around who can inspire you to work harder. And India is a very inspirational country. I do believe that with all the pain that we go through, all the tough times, but Indians, I mean, recently, taking the focus off from me, I'm taking it to the sports arena. I was blown over by Neeraj Chopra's javelin throw. You know, I was blown over by the hockey team. Those girls, they came
even the girls,
the
yeah.
They came fourth in the rankings, and then I was blown over by Lovlina's boxing grit and determination. Super. And these guys are all preparing for 2024. So for me, when I was seeing the fitness levels of this boy in this show, I said, God, what? So he provoked me. So I said, let's do something more. So I started making tunes that day. I said, this is the only time. I'm not a sports person. I was appreciating. I was clapping when the tricolors, when our national anthem was played. I was standing in my house, and all me, my wife, my 2 kids, we were saluting the tricolor. It was an emotional moment because to get gold at the age of 23 and for our country, it was huge. So I made a lot of songs that day. Out of these 10 tunes, Anmol tells me, Adha tells me, Dad, those cue tunes are fantastic. I said that comes from the inspiration I got from Neeraj Chopra. So you can get inspiration from anywhere, and you want to keep on going because others inspire you.
Did you send him the tune, the inspirational bit that you did?
I have spoken on the. There was a lovely interview done 2 days back, and they said, "Will you like it if they come to your house for a cup of tea?" I said, "I'll make the tea myself," and then I started singing "Garam Chai Ki Pehli Ho." So it was amazing. I would love it if they come to my house.
And if he, I would love it if he comes to my house because I got a lot of neighbors that irritate me. I'll give him chota javelin. Wahan pe. You know? Can you imagine? Sharma's gone. Verma's gone. Parekh's gone. Mehta's gone. All in a few seconds.
Oh my god. It's amazing. All right.
Let's get back to you. One confession. We have played you on our show a few times. Of course, there must have been a reason. I can't remember where, but we have. And I think Gopal is the one who does your knuckle. He doesn't do... It's not the best ever, but it's there somewhere. The other thing is that one song in our generation in MTV, which every monsoon became such a cliche that we could... It replaced all the monsoons and holy songs that we had before.
You can see me smiling. I know where you're coming from.
Dekho barish ho rahi hai. I'm just thinking, we parodied that about 3 or 4 times. But it's actually a complete salute to through that song that it became the monsoon song from whenever it was launched, I think around the late 90s, early 2000s, till today. Till today, we use that reference, not just us, people in the newspapers, in different languages, across the television, across web portals. So, I mean, what do you feel when you become iconic enough that just something of yours it'll last forever? It's just there.
No, it was fun because, you know, that time I wanted to be different. I always wanted to be different. If you go back to all my songs, like Kali Kali Aankhein or anyone, I used to add. Yeah. So I used to add a lot of English words in those days. Which is not very well.
That's right.
Like, my adorable darling. So I used the word mad, M-A-D, mad. And I said, so many of my producers and directors said, why are you doing this? But I said, no, it's going to survive the test of time. Now with this, they had made a lot of songs in Barish on Sawan Aaya, Jhumke and everything. So as a kid, when I was only 20, I said, why? I mean, every song is Barkha, Bahar. They are fantastic numbers. But I want to be different. All those songs were great, sung by the legendary singers. But I said, why can't I be different for a rain song? And this hit me. Dekho Barish Ho Rahi Hai. That's okay. Dekho Na Dekho. It's raining. It's raining.
It's raining.
When you put those English words with the Hindi words, in those days, it really caught the imagination. And
it matched perfectly also.
Yeah.
It matched.
Dekho barish ho rahi hai. Dekho na dekho. It's raining. It's raining. It's raining. Mera dil ro raha hai. Dekho na dekho. It's raining. It's raining. Tere liye. Tere liye. Tere liye, tere liye. So the thing is, the barish ho rahi is raining. Mera dil ro raha, it's raining. So people love this idea. And whenever it rains, many people come and tell me that the moment it rains, we think of the song. So I think I take it as a compliment.
Also, I think what it is, now that you mention it and it strikes me, it became for the English generation of the 90s onwards, where they speak the mixed language and all that. It became a song which sort of was cool, you know, for them. Because it's not very highfalutin Hindi lyrics, which you sometimes feel is your father's generation.
I was lucky that my Audi company chose that song. It was from Magna Sound in those days, Shashi Gopal. So he said, okay, Anu. So he said, Anu, I love this and go for it. I said, okay, sir, are you sure? I said, yeah, and there's a story behind it because I remember when I was in college in those days and I had a tiff with my... She was my girlfriend at the time, who's now my wife.
Are so, Papa. It's so, raining. It's raining.
There's a story behind this. So she said, I know.
You're looking to check if she's there.
Yes, she is there. She's smiling.
The great Anu Malik in his moment of fear. Bolo.
Moment of fear to hai na, Baba. He said, darana, wife should not look like that. But then I went to Khandala, Lunavala, and it was raining. And I love the rains. So I was missing her hell of a lot. So I thought... Well, actually, the mukhra just came out. It just, dekho barish ho rahi hai, dekho na dekho. It's raining, it's raining, it's raining. And mera dil ro raha hai, it's raining. And I was missing her. And when I got the whole mukhra, came back here, hummed it to my producer, and the rest is history.
Wow. So you think all your songs have just come like that? They come into your head and you just sort of go with it? Or have you ever sat? How
no,
does
no.
Anuma
I have go? Sat. I mean, coming down to 2016, I had a lot of hard work. I pushed in for a film called Dam Laga Ke Aisha. The song Momo Ke Dhage got in 3 national awards. And I worked very, very hard on songs which required my attention in a big way. There's been Rajkumar Hirani when I did Munna Bhai MBBS. That required a lot of hard work with Mr. Vidhu Vinod Chopra and Rajkumar Hirani. There's been Mr. J.P. Dutta's Border, Refugee, LOC, Kargil, Umrah Jaan. Many, you know, sadly, many people don't even know that I've composed music for a lot of films. So they don't know, oh, this is your song. For example, many people come up to me and say, Ashoka is yours. I said, yes. I've done a lot of Shah Rukh films, right? From Bazigar to Ashoka to Chahat to Mehuna. When Farah Khan came to me and said, I want something very, very different from you. And Mehuna got me my 3rd Filmfare Award. Bazigar was the first, Fiza was the second. So there are times when you have to really go into the character and work hard on the music. And I remember with Rakesh Mehra, Rakesh Mehra's first film was Aks. Aja Gufao Mea, Aja Guna Karale with Gulzar Uncle writing the lyrics. There was Filhal with Meghna Gulzar. There was Ashoka with Santosh Sewal. There was Janemal with Farah's husband Shirish Kundar, which is incidentally one of my favorite musical albums. If you pick up that album, Janeman. So when you have to sit and work hard, you really have to work hard. So I have a different side to my personality. I'll give you a garam chai ki pyaali ho. I'll give you a uchi hai building lift teri band hai. And I'll also give you a Sunday se aate hain. And I'll also give you a Mehuna. I'll also give you a Sori Mehwal. I'll give you a Mar Tange Wala with Manmohan Desai. So I was 21 when I started working with Mr. Bachchan and Manmohan Desai.
But as you became who you became, would the heroes and the big producer directors, would they interfere with you? How does it work? Because you're Anu Malik, your brand Anu Malik, and you know, egos in Bollywood and all that.
I don't think so. For example, when I was with Salman, I remember Salman was a great inspiration for the film Judwa. You know, Salman was really hip hop and happening. He still is. At that time, I remember when I met him, he met me outside a studio somewhere in Juhu and said, look, we have been signed up with Sajid Narayanwala. I said, yeah. So all he said, all the brief that he gave me was, Anu, give me something very, very, you know, musty, something very different. And that became my inspiration because when I looked at Salman, I found a lot of impishness on his face and the way, the swag, the way he was walking. And many of my tunes came out looking at Salman. For example, Uchiya Building, Lift Teri Band Hai, typical Salman, Aja, 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 Bad. So they never interfered. And in fact, I got inspired by Shah Rukh, Salman, Aamir, Akshay Kumar, even to a large extent, when I came to know I'm doing Mard, I was inspired. I was lucky enough to get great heroes for my film, Cyrus. I'll be very honest with you. Now, in India, you may be a brand, but you need a great face to your music. You know, a great face, for example, if you have a Karishma Kapoor or a Kareena or a Deepika or a Katrina. In those days, I got great, great actors, Anushka. Now, you know, the song really takes off when you have a great actor performing. So when I had a Shah Rukh for Bazigar and Kajol, so it really worked. I've been blessed that I got great actors and great people, apart from producers and directors, who helped me to become what I am today.
Okay, let me ask you, because in interest of time, you have to get the Silvery in and their questions for you. But I want to ask you a difficult question. What would be Anu Malik's favorite Anu Malik composition? Is it possible to have one? But there might be a reason beyond just the music.
You know, it's going to be very, very difficult to answer this one. Because I love all my compositions. Some work, some don't work, you know. But at times, being a patriotic Indian, I have always loved my song Sandesh Se Aate Hain for a lot of reasons.
Love that song. What a song.
I love it. I love it because when I made the song, I was literally in tears. I remember Javed Saab writing the words and J.P. Dutta saying that it could take a long time for him to compose. But then I was moved by the stories about our Indian Army, the way they protect us and in such arduous conditions, tough conditions. And I was moved that they are away from the families, away from their loved ones, and they just love the motherland. And that feeling of loving a motherland is nothing bigger than that. So for me, that song remains my favorite. And I still feel that really is a song that came literally right from my heart for the people of India, for my Indian Army, for the Indian Air Force, for the Navy, everyone. I salute my country. I love my motherland like all of us.
It's, It's like a perfect. India. It's like a perfect song. I can praise it rather than let me praise it. It's just perfect because you know it brings out that whole emotion. Of course, the visuals are there as well. I mean, the idea of a 4G writing a letter or receiving a letter, you know, that just that emotive content in that is enough. But then to match it perfectly with the kind of melody and lyrics, where it's haunting. It leaves you. I mean, it just changes the mood completely in that one split second. So I would say it's one of my Anu Malik favorite songs of all time, no question. Favorite singer? Is there a favorite singer? Again, mean question.
I think right from the time I grew up, I've loved legendary Lata Ji and Asha Ji and Kishorda and Rafi Saab. And today, you know, when I was working with Sonu and Roop Ji and Abhijit and Vinod Rathod, and then there was Alka Ji, all the way down to Shreya, Sunidhi, and now to my daughter Anmol. I mean, I've loved all my singers, respected all my singers. I would not be Anu Malik without the love and support of these great singers. You know, for me, when I started out, I had Asha Ji singing for me and Lata Ji singing for me. Today, a year back, I recorded a song with Arjit and I love his voice. Now, I'm loving all the Indian Idol singers. I'll be very honest with you. We have such fabulous singers on Indian Idol. I can't even tell you how talented they are. So, I think I love all my singers. I love all my lyric writers. You never ask me about my lyricists, but to me, a Javed Akhtar, a Gulzar Sahab, an Anand Bakshi, a Sameer, a Varun Grover. Varun Grover is one of my favorite lyricists. And there is Manoj Muntashir also now, who's really doing a fabulous
Let's enjoy
job.
Varun Grover while we can. Because
oh my God, later. He's amazing. He's amazing.
I'm just worried.
I love my lyric writers. I respect all my great talented singers. I know it's not a cliche, but sometimes when you make a great song, and I just wait for my singer to pull the song through. So all these singers, male and female, have really... Sandeep Se Aate would not have been possible without Roop and Sonuji's voice. And all my songs...
Hey, Anu, this has become a film fair speech now.
I know that. So I'm going to go over that and say, East or West, Anu Malik is the best. How do you like that?
That's also a song. East or West.
I made that. Yeah, ki ladki, wah wah. Badan pisadi, wah wah. Kano me bali, wah wah. Hoto pilali, wah wah. Sare jahan se acha hindusta hamara hum bulbulen hai iski ye gulsta hamara yo east or west india is the best
the
garam chai ki pyale ho koi usko pilane wali ho aur unchi hai building lift teri band hai not become Anu Malik show and I know you're getting the best.
Oh listen man, we're getting it free. You keep performing. I'm not going to interrupt you.
Anytime for you, Cyrus. Anything for you because you deserve this kind of respect. If it's free, it's free for you.
No, come on. You're one of the real legends. It's so nice to have you on. You have no idea. Again, whole team, everybody's very, very excited to have you here. But one quick question, we're going to a break. One quick question for the family. So does Anmol, I mean, how does that dynamic work? I remember talking to Sachin Pilgaonkar's daughter. You know, when you have a big name in the family and all that, do you tell her what to do? I mean, or is she your boss?
I'll tell you something about Anmol. No, I'll tell you something about now that you asked about Anmol, which she told me, Daddy, no one asked. First thing she said, if no one asked about me, no one will speak about me. So now that you asked about Anmol.
It sounds like my kids.
They say that.
So they're always embarrassed about what I'm going to say.
Daddy,
it's like
your,
good
Dad, it's your interview. Dad, it's your interview. Talk about yourself. If somebody questions you about me, then talk about me. So now that you question about Anmol, I'll tell you. Anmol and Ada, I've got two daughters. Huh. Anmol has studied from Warwick University, Coventry. She's a graduate from media and computers. You know, she's done that course.
They allow you to mix everything in those countries, yes?
Yeah. And she just wrote a book called Three Impossible Wishes, which was released by HarperCollins. Which I think was something right out of my zone. She wrote the entire book and the book has done exceedingly well. Apart from that, she's a fabulous singer. And so that when she sang Chura Ke Dil Mera recently and got so many views and she got it on her merit. So I was very happy that she sang this number, Chura Ke Dil Mera again. Ada is a fashion designer and she studied from New York, from Parsons University. Wow. She designs clothes. So she's into her own designing and she's doing great. So I'm grateful to God that my wife insisted that they educate themselves and stand on their own feet at the end of the day. But now if they are creatively inclined, I've told them you can do whatever you want, but they're doing what they feel they should do, and I'm very happy for them.
And who's the boss between Anu Malik and Anmol when they perform together or work together?
Honestly, Anmol listens to me, but only to a point. And then she takes over. And when she takes over, she takes over.
See, you're not prepared for this one. Now, with all your talent and status, end of the day, also just a father. So there's a line.
Finally, we both are, you know.
Yeah, you're telling me, I'm such a weak father. I was hoping to be inspired that you said, main chappal nikal ke maarte
sare. Nahi nahi kuch nahi kuch nahi kuch nahi. Hum log I when I enter my house, I'm on my best manners. Is anyone happy? And she is a hygiene freak. Moment I come and have a bath, wash your hand. Uske baad, I know why you're doing this. Tere saath bhi hota hoga. Can't sit on the
completely, dining table. Completely.
You can't eat till you've had a completely. And then when she knows daddy is completely clean, she'll come and hug me. So it's Anna is the same thing.
How did we lose control? Anu, how did we lose control? They were little kids and they were following you everywhere. And
suddenly we lost control. But I love it. I love that. Yeah.
Now we can't do anything. We're a bit like the country. What can we do now? We can't do anything.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Sir, did you do the needful and clap and all that when lockdown one and, you know, shut the lights for 9 minutes or...
Oh, yeah. I did everything. And I believe in everything. Anything that can drive away this God-forsaken COVID away. But the good news is we have fought it. All of us have fought it. My heart goes out to the people who... the families who unfortunately lost their loved ones. But it's been a tough fight for all. We're still fighting. But I think the basic things that I've learned is masking, washing your hands, standing 2 feet apart as much as we can.
Yeah, well, the way I see it, if there's no solution, you just keep going. There's
no point thinking it's tough. About it too much. I'm so happy to meet you even virtually. At least there's some semblance of life around just talking because I was starved, you know, like all of us staying at home and not interacting with people and friends. It was the toughest time of our lives.
Especially for your kind of lifestyle, we're always out of the house working in studios and...
No, we work in studios, we meet friends, we... After a hard day's work, we want to chit-chat and meet people. And nothing of that sort was happening. And all around there was fear. And that is the fear I fought through my music. And I wanted the people to get a dose of my music. So I started making songs, trying to make people happy as much as I can. Because I want people to love life and to understand. You know, recently, I had a major tragedy. Just a few days back, and I unfortunately lost my mom. So
sorry to
hear that. That has been a big blow to me and my family. But you know, I still was working. The show must go on. I believe in that. Raj Kapoor Saab's line: the show must go on. We have to keep on working and smiling, in spite of all the pain that we are going through. You know, we have to go through all this pain to make a certain person out there smile because he or she is going through their pain. You know. So we have to forget our pain and make the people smile.
But from what I gather, Anuji, you are the guy who actually uses all these negatives in a sense to get the best out of yourself.
I believe that if you know, sadness, I'm not a guy who's going to do pravachan, but I do believe when there's a lot of negativity around you, you have to not only forget, but also never hate anybody. Because in my being, I am not born with hatred. I'm not born with viciousness. I believe in respecting people and making people happy. So if somebody's creating negativity, we have to think of positive thoughts. I read stories that about valor, about people who came up through the hardship. I read a great lot of stories how people survived. I read stories about great Hollywood actors, great Indian actors, and
like the
how
Indian women's hockey team.
Sorry,
the Indian women's hockey team. What an inspiration!
Oh yes, one, apart from the hockey team, which, oh my God, that story is so tough for the girl whose father was a card puller and she made it to the hockey team. About Lovlina, who stayed away from her family for 8 years just to learn boxing. Not even 8 days.
As a kid, as a child.
So for me, these are great stories of valor and I surround myself with these stories about how people have come up through the grit and determination. And that makes me Anu Malik. Then I keep on making music and I keep on inspiring myself.
Yeah, I think this. So we've got two things in common. But one thing I tell you, sir, you shouldn't join politics because you're not vicious enough. If you're not vicious enough, politics is not the game for you.
But I like to help people of the country from outside. I will never join politics. That's not something.
If you want to help people, you can't join politics.
No, but I like helping a lot of people. I do that on the side. do that in my own way, but I'm not going to even mention what I do. But there are people who find out this is what I'm doing. So, but I say, don't write about it. But I like helping people as much as I can. That gives me a great high of seeing a person smile.
Okay, you're making us all smile here. But let's call in Silvery. We're taking a quick break of 3 seconds as Silvery comes in. And now we're going to go to the AMAs and questions from people who are watching the show. Because I think okay. I've spoken too much and they want more from you. Silvery, say hi.
Hi, good morning. Hello, hello, Malik. Hello, hello, sir.
Morning.
How are you doing, sir?
Good morning.
Big fan. Big fan, sir.
Yeah. Thank you.
Of course, yes, I do know Adar Malik, yes. Yes, huge fan of Adar Malik also. Yes.
Who's also quite a decent, all the Maliks are singers, without exception. Everyone has got music in the genes. Yeah,
sir. So what do you think of the current era of the Malik family dominating the music space in the industry right now? So you have a comedian, you have multiple music composers.
You know, I'm very excited about the fact that my brother's two children, Amar and Arman, have done exceedingly well in terms of music. I love Adar very, very much for what he's done. He's taken a step backwards and done something which we never thought we could do. I love my daughter Anmol for the fact that she not only is a composer, singer, but now when she sang Churake Dil Mera and got 24, 25 million views, it was amazing because she got a call from Priya Darshan and Ratan Jain to sing the song. And I took that very happily because she was asked to sing. And then when she wrote a book called Three Impossible Wishes, when Anmol wrote this book, and she surprised me that she's written this book, it was a huge high for me that she's a writer, writing books, and the book was well received by all the youngsters. So it gives me a great high to know my family is taking this legacy forward.
Oh, and it's a happy family. There's no question of one-upmanship. I mean, little competition is
no, good. Not at all. In fact, we love each other. In fact, we've always been very, very close. We all three brothers and our children. Because I personally believe, at the end of the day, I'm there to guide them as much as I can. When Anmol and I need my guidance, I'm always there. And basically, I respect the talent. You know, no one has come up by seeking anyone's help. Now, this is something very I never sought anyone's help to come up in life. Anmol didn't ask my help to. I don't know how to write a book. I don't know how to write a sentence, what she's written. So she didn't ask me about how, daddy, I'm going to approach. So they have all the entire family members, including Adar or Amar or Arman, have come up on their own. And that is what I respect.
Why is everybody named with A?
Absolutely.
That's funny, no? That's a good question. But then it is A, everyone. So fine. A for Anno, A for Anju, A for Anmol, A for Adan. I love that A.
So that's obviously deliberate, right?
No, it just came to me.
No, come on. Really?
I mean it. When Anmol, you know, when we had some, Anju had some problems, and I remember a doctor wrote, take care of the precious baby. I said, I translated the word precious, and precious Anmol. So I said, let's name her Anmol. And with Adha, it was beautiful because Adha, when she was born, I don't know how she yawned like that. I know she did sometime when she was just small. I said, "He kya Adha hai?" So I said, let's name her Adha. So there's a story behind everything.
Okay, sir. Can't argue with that. Can we, Silvery, get the AMAs in?
Yeah, absolutely. I have one more question, if I could. Sir, okay. I've always wondered this. Like, when it comes to music composition, how important does the script of the movie become? Because nowadays, at least, I have seen that a lot of songs could be inserted into almost any film. But particularly in your films, like, say, Mehuna, the song is deliberately put a particular place, it's thought of a particular way. Mehuna turns out to be is one of my favorite albums. That's why the reference. But yeah.
Okay, so let me answer this. When I was doing Mehuna, Farah Khan came to me and told me, give me an idea. Look, I want very, very funky, very different music from you. And she's a real, real, real fan of melody. And she said, Anu, I just want you to be yourself and give me something which... And I believe in the fact that Raj Kapoor had said, there is a situation for a good song. Farah believes in that. She felt that if the song is good, she gave a brief outline to a situation. This is what Shahrukh would be saying. For example, Mehuna, the title track was born how? Javed Saab was told the situation by Farah. And when Javed Saab came to my music room in Juhu, we sat down. He wrote something which Farah felt could have been better. So I suddenly said, I could see the stress between Farah and Javed uncle at that time. So I said, Javed Saab, I said, Farah, what's the name of the film? How a song is born? She said, Mehuna. So what I did was, I started humming. Ta-ra-dee-ra-ra-ra, ta-ra-ra. And then I said, Mehuna. And Javed Saab loved that idea. So you can't believe it. Javed Saab wrote those words in front of me and Farah. Kiska hai ye tumko intezaar main hu. He got inspired by the way I said, Mehuna. So I'm there. Now. If you have a problem, Mehuna. Dekh lo idhar to ek baar Mehuna. And the entire song was written by Javed Saab in the sitting room in front of me. And Farah jumped and said, we have a song. So you need a director like Farah to also decide that this is the song I want. Now, in terms of a film like Border, I was given the situation that this is a song which I need. The armies, you know, in Siachen border, and they are missing their loved ones. One, they are writing letters to their loved ones. And then Javed Saab wrote the entire song. And that was more like prose, less than poetry. For example, the words that were given to me were was like, Sandeh se aate hain, hame tarpate hain, jo chitti aati hai, wo puchhe jaati hai, ki ghar kab aoge, ay guzarne wali hawa bata, mera itna kaam kare. So more like prose. So I said, where am I going to start? How am I going to make this song? Because it doesn't have a Mukhra Antra format. But then the emotions took over of the soldiers. And the tune came out from that line. Ay guzarne wali hawa bata, mera itna kaam karegi kya, mere gaon ja. So the tune came out from me through emotion. Now, when I worked with Sharat Kataria for a film, Dam Laga Ke Haisha, I read the entire script 10 times. 10 times I read the script. Because he wanted songs to suit every situation. When Aditya Chopra called me, and when Manish Sharma and Adi, Manish was the producer, Aditya Chopra, president of the film, Sharat said, read the script. I read the script 10 times, I read Sui Thaga 10 times, because he believes in the situation. So it works both the ways for me. Either you want something, I'll give it to you. David Dhawan, for example, when I'm working with David Dhawan, what is mobile number? Karu kya dial number? Karni hai tumse baate. Dede koi easy number. Tanan tan 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 tan. David and Sergeant Nidarwal jumped and kissed me. This is a song. There was no situation. It was just Govinda and Karishma. Wow. So wow. It was fun. Again for Judwa, I said, Uchi hai building. Now Sajid is just sitting and hearing me. Sajid Nidarwala and David said, what Uchi hai building? Live teri band hai. I was just having fun. Kaise main aao, dil raza mand hai. Suddenly they all look at each other. Are kya mukra yaar, Salman bhai ke liye fantastic. Wapis ga. I just started singing, Uchi hai building. And then I added, oh, aja, 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 band, baja leke. And they said, record. We recorded the song the next day. So some songs are born like that. Some songs are born with the script. Some songs are born when the director insists, okay, tum karo, hum jama lenge. So it works every way, for me at least.
Wow, amazing. So like, does it sometimes take you like really long? Can it like take up to like months, maybe even, to think of a song?
Yeah, I think some songs took a long time. For example, two of my albums took a long time. Janiman, you must pick up that album.
Lovely album, sir. Yeah, sir.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite. Then Ashoka with Santosh Sivan. Yeah. Because Santosh Sivan, he's cameraman. But when I got this film, Santosh insisted, I don't want any instrument that, because it was set in prehistoric times. So you can't play this, you can't play a guitar. I and my sound producer, Ranjit Barot, Ranjit, whom I love very much, he's my Jan, he's my friend. He said, how are we going to work on this? How are we going to work on this? And then there's a song in the film, Raat ka nasha abhi aankh se. We use minimum rhythm, we use bamboo sticks, crack, kuch, and we use Chitra Ma's voice. And, you know, and Gulzar uncle wrote, what beautiful. So when I made the tune, Raat ka nasha abhi. So we played with one flute.
I think the entire
Mukhra was being played on the flute and bamboo sticks.
Santosh was just using this as an excuse to save money and budget. It's put the history point out. And
that is, Shahrukh was a producer. Shahrukh said, go ahead and use any instrument. But Santosh Sivan, but that's my favorite album. There's another favorite album of mine, Ux, with Rakesh Mehra. That was his first film. So there are a lot of albums which I've loved. I love Meghna Gulzar's album. Check it out, Filhal. Then Khalid Mohammed made me work on a film called Fizza, which got me my second Filmfare Award. The songs are, you know, doing well even today.
My God, how many awards would you have won over the years?
I've got 3 Filmfare Awards, 1 national award. And I'm grateful to the country, to the people of India. Honestly, if you call it a Filmfare speech, but I must say that the people have loved my music. I've got a lot of nominations, and I'm grateful to God for everything.
Padma Vibhushan, coming soon.
Sir, I'm telling you, पहले पद्मश्री मिल जाए बहुत बड़ी बात होगी. पद्म विभूषण वेरी फार.
जंप मार के पद्म विभूषण पहुंच गए हम लोग. Nothing less, sir. Nothing less. I am going to make
my award is your love, Cyrus. My award is the love of the people of India who always
take the Vibhushan. Take the Vibhushan over us.
See, this is what I'm doing for my great country, India. I'm grateful to God that I'm born here.
See, I love the emotive content of your music. I think people get very worried to show their emotions sometimes. One of the problems in our country, but I think your music really reflects that bindas, because that sense of art is there. You know you don't care what other people think. This is your emotion. This is what you're going to say. And then you have some brilliant pieces, like all the songs in Border, not just Sandesh Se Aate. I think all of them were brilliant. But let's get these questions in, bro. The people are trying to ask questions. I want to answer some. I can't keep it forever.
Yeah. All right. Sorry. All right. The first one comes in from Kashin Shetty. He says, hello, Anuji. For me, 1997 Hi. Was your golden year with your music for Judwa, Virasat and Border, exploring such variety and are still timeless soundtracks. Of these three, which is closest to your heart? I mean, I'm sure
that's all question. Of them, because they have Judwa is completely different from Virasat, and Virasat is completely different Border. Now, I want to tell you something. There's a story behind this. When Cyrus asked me which you've got a lot of awards, there was a lot of pain here. I was nominated for Virasat and Border, and I did not get an award for any of them. And that was the pain. I remember there was a story. I was sitting in the audience with my wife, and Anmol was very small at the time. When my name was on, she called me up, Daddy, did you get an award for Virasat or Border? And at that time, they said the award goes to some other composer. And I was shocked, because I'd given my best to Virasat, songs like Dhol Bajne Laga and Sandesh Se Aate. But that's happened to the best composers. I calmed down when I came to know that Panchamda had not got awards for so many of his great compositions, when the great Madan Mohan Ji never got awards for his great compositions. So it happens to the best of us. But why I love all the three, I've always loved Panchamda, because Pancham could give you a Tisri Manzil and also give you an Amar Prem, There are two different genres of music. So people came up to me and said, you gave a Judwa with the Oshi building, and then you gave a Sandesh Se Aate Hain, and then you gave a Virasat. So this shows your versatility, and I take that as a compliment. So all three are my favorites.
I'll give you my pearls of wisdom. Mm-hmm. I believe if you win the award has got a lot of meaning and you should respect it. And if you don't win the award was rubbish. This is the way to approach things.
My God. Yeah, I said, go ahead. But when I don't get an award, I move on to the next album and give it my best shot. So that's saying that, Cyrus, it happens to all of us. We give our best. That pat on the back is a little encouraging. Okay, it's a human tendency to say, like when I used to make a good song, I used to run to my mother and she's saying, good job. I come home today also when I make a song and my wife says, great song. So I like that.
What? In the Zindagi Ka Safar, which is your music journey, how does it even matter? I mean, you've got so many big hits, so many great albums, so many memories.
Honestly, now what matters is when people love my music. It doesn't matter. I'm grateful to God for what. I have no complaints. I have no regrets. I'm grateful to God. In fact, the only thing is that I wish I had more work now, because I love working. So people say, "Tumne itna kaam kiya." I said, "Maine kuch nahi kiya. Mujhe aur kaam karna."
Well, on the bright side, during lockdown, you have work at home, domestic work which has to be done.
So, oh my God! Don't even ask me.
Don't ask.
Congratulations.
Me.
Every morning I make my own bed.
How many years every of marriage?
Morning, every morning. This has happened in the last two years. I enjoy making my bed. And if I have to wash dishes, I don't mind that. But then everyone is working at home. And I think Gana na saathi aath banana. We have to help. We have to help each other.
Kaisa life mein parivartan aa gaya ki Anu Malik, after reaching the top of his line and fame, is now told to make the bed, then clean the
buttons. But I'm enjoying it.
Yeah. Life is a great equalizer. Come on, let's try and get a couple more, at least.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely. And then next one comes in from Girish Patil. He says, Anuji, what was the reason behind the green shirt you wore for India and Mumbai Indian matches? Is it your lucky
dish? Yeah.
Okay, so I'm a big Mumbai Indian fan, and I support the Mumbai Indians team forever and ever and ever. as long as the world exists. So I went to the match, and always wearing the Mumbai Indian t-shirt. I'd worn a green shirt that day. So when I walked in, one wicket of the opposite team fell down. So I remember I was sitting in the box with the family, and someone saw, yaar, wicket gir gaya. So I said, 1 minute, I'm going to sit with this green shirt. They came out with the Mumbai Indian shirt. I said, wait, 5 minutes, dusra wicket gira. Then I said, somebody said, from the family, are ye achha lag raha hai dusra. I said, please don't change this shirt, please. So suddenly we won the match with the green shirt. So everyone, I said, I'm going to wear this green shirt. They said, okay, you wear the green shirt and come for all the matches. So I always wear the green shirt. I'm standing there with the green shirt, encouraging Mumbai Indians. The best team in the world.
This is a superstition which is very popular with sports people. If they win in a certain outfit, shoes, socks, shirt, pant, for cricketers, you know, even Abdi Guard, they never change it. They're highly superstitious people.
Cyrus, I don't know about you, but if I'm sitting in one place where I'm recording a song and the singer sings it perfectly, I'm not changing till the whole song is over. I'm not getting up because I want the song to be good. So it's you can call it OCD, you can call it superstition, you can call it whatever. But I believe in the green shirt, I'm going to wear it.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe these are all the small things that make you, you know, have this long run and, you know, keep up the good work. Who
I don't know what it is, but I stick to my.
See, we make fun.
I am superstitious. I'm a firm believer in God. I'm a firm believer in God and destiny, and I'm a firm believer in hard work, and I'm a firm believer in abhi yahan baitho yahi baitho. But then,
no,
come
I,
on.
I'm not going to be funny about this. I sort of understand where you're coming from. You know, last year when the work started drying up after lockdown one, I slept the other way around to get the AC on my face. That means my feet next to my wife's face and my head here, so I get more AC because it was very hot. Only for that reason, the next day the phone rang and some major work came in. So after that, I got worried. Second day, I did the same thing. Again, another event came. So uske baad, I've been sleeping like that. My wife is asking, what are you doing? I said, boss, listen, we have to run the house and everything. I can't change. So I totally understand where you're coming from. And it's not a joke. It's funny when we tell the story, but I still do that. And she's like, you know, in any case, we have a horrible married life. And now this, you know, my feet, your face. That's the situation. But I can't take a chance. Yeah, boy, mutual fund ka jaise
insurance. This is why I love you so much. This is why I love the way you twist things around and make people smile.
I swear this is true, Anu. And because you had the guts to tell me your story, that you're sitting there, I mean, 4 or 5 verses, hours you're talking about a guy singing a song, not 10 minutes, and you did not move. And so
but
I knew you
like this. But then, ulta bhi hua. Sometimes when I move, the song has become a hit. So I don't know what to believe.
Oh, it's great. Unbelievable. Even the greats are just human. This is beautiful. I love all these stories. Okay, Sylvie, next.
All right. The next one comes in from Abhik Ghosh. He says, "Sir, did movie music ever feel like a restriction to you? Did you ever think of creating albums not necessary for movies?"
Yeah, I've always thought of creating albums also. But at that time when I started, there were a lot of movies coming along, and I was composing a lot for films in those days. But today, I think then I started composing albums. Now singles are the in thing. You know, you make one song. That becomes a huge hit, and technology has advanced to such an extent, you make a song, release it on your own YouTube channel, and if it is a great song, people pick it up. So things have changed. Remember in those days, Cyrus, we used to work on a live orchestra. You know, we had an ensemble of...
And you do the whole take again, no?
40
You do the whole take again, right?
Full. And if somebody sang wrong or the musician played wrong, we had to go back again and do the whole thing again. Today, because I work on a Logic, I work on a Nuendo, I work on a Cubase, things have changed. You know, we can edit, we can do so much thanks to technology. Things have changed.
So, imagine, were you sitting on the same chair when you started out and the whole orchestra was playing?
Frankly, in those days, I never knew what OCD or same chair was. All I thought, okay, next...
It comes after the success.
When will the next film come my way? And sometimes I believe in OCD, and sometimes it always happens, you know, things have not worked according to the way you thought. You may sit on the same chair for hours and something else happens. So, you know, it keeps on changing. We actually feel that it is because of that OCD thing, that superstition thing, that things are working. No. At the end of the decide is, like a doctor says, if you're not well, you have to take an FDA approved drug. You know, finally, that's going to work for you. Nothing else works. And I've tried that. finally, it's the doctor who works. So if your hard work is good, if you make a good song, if you know in your heart it's a good song, it's bound to work. You can't make the song work by, I suddenly, because I want the interview to be good, I suddenly disappear from.
But you still have the superstition, no matter what you say.
We all have superstitions. But I try to curb them also. I try to control them also, because it can get the better of you.
Fair enough. But I want to know this. Did you, in the early days, before all this software came about, did you ever have a song perfect right till the last note? And the last line or note, the guy, the one violinist is off or something, and you do the whole thing again. Has it ever been like that close to perfect?
Tarek, how come you know so much about my music? This really happened. The song was Bazigar Main Bazigar.
What are you saying?
Now listen to me. This song was being recorded at Mehboob Studios. The entire take was ready. Alkaji and Shahrukh were on the mic. The musicians, the 100-piece orchestra. In those days, we had a 2-inch tape. And there was a tape running. Okay? The entire song started, and people, when the song ended, everyone in the music room clapped. The producer, the directors, Abbas Mastan, my producer, Ratan Jain, and Shahrukh and Kajol, and everyone, the whole ensemble of people, and we were clapping. What a song! I mean, everyone's suddenly the door opens, and one head pops in from the recorders. Sir, tape ran out, ho gaya, sir. Gana pura record nahi hua. We died there. There was so much depression that the song was not recorded, and to motivate all the musicians, to motivate the singers, and in spite of that, the song is a big hit even today. I remember I took a big break. I cried. I went to the loo and cried, because if I was raw, I was new, and I had dirty thoughts, strange thoughts coming in my head. God, I hope the producer doesn't leave me. I hope the director doesn't say now, bas abhi nahi karne ka. You know, those are the fears of a young boy. You know, when you're just 22 or 23 and you're scared, you don't want the film to get out of your hand. I went to the loo and I started sobbing. Nobody knows that I'm saying this today to you. I put a lot of water on my face, went back to the music room, made Alka and Shanu sit down, say, let's do it again. Went to the musicians, hugged all of them. Thank you for playing so well. Let's give it one more try. Went to the recorders. I said, for God's sake, if the tape runs out, to they kabhi kya hone wala? Bole kuch nahi. That poor guy got the tapes fixed. It took 2 hours to get the whole thing set up again. I gave them a tea break, and what I don't remember what happened. After a lot of hugs and tali bajana and motivation, we said, 1, 2, 3, start. Gana ho gaya. In the mixing, finally found the song was given to the producer. And in one track, the violins were still missing. So in one track, you find violins missing. Still, the song became a super hit. There was so much
anxiety. You didn't
redo it. Nobody came to know what.
Wow. Wow, I'm just saying. God,
I've gone through those emotions. It's been fearful. Because recording live is a different ballgame altogether.
Really? I remember dubbing something in the early days in the 90s, where you have to get it all spot on. It was a Russian film. And now you can do one word. It's so easy, you can do it at home. I mean, it's ridiculous. You don't have to worry about missing the beat or anything. You just dub onto the word with one word at a time.
My God.
Anyway, chalo, let's take one more. Silvery?
All right, sure. This last one is just a request from a fan. She says, Hero Shukla, can you both, Cyrus and Anuji, sing a song together?
Sure. So I was saying Uchiye Building, and Cyrus was saying Aja Aja, Madam Aja Legia.
Done.
Ho jaye?
Zero, you also joined in.
Let's entertain our fans.
Yeah. Will you sing the tune properly once, sir?
Jo bhi tu gaata masti mein ga. Uchiye Building.
Aja Aja. Aja, aja.
Kaise main aau?
Aja,
are
aja.
Are dil ra samandh hai, sing.
Aja, aja.
Acha, aja, aja, band baja leke aja. Teri yaad sataye dulhe raja, o tu aja. Kaise?
Aja, 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 aja band aja. Baja leke aja. Teri yaad sataye dulhe raja, ab to aja. Kaise? Someone said, why did you say kaise, not kaise? I said, Salman Khan, kaise bolega? Kaise? So I said, Salman will look very smart when saying, kaise, that's Salman. So I did it his style.
And it worked. I hope they pay you some of their money, these heroes. What the hell, yaar? So you make them great.
They paid me. They pay me. They pay me through the love. They give me a lot of love. Shah Rukh, Salman.
That's what we are offering on the podcast. Anuji, it's love. We are paying in love. Zyada dena, sir. Sir, ko zyada dena, silvery.
Dena, dena, pyar dena. I said I've come to the show not for love, not only for love, but also for Cyrus and the love of the people of India. And Cyrus, you are a fabulous host. So I would never ask a single paisa from you. You're a friend first and then everything else.
I mean, this is amazing. Thank you so much for saying that. I hope it's true, Anu. We're always big fans of yours. And like I said, I mean, going strong.
It's totally true. I would not be. I slept at 6 in the morning. I'm shooting for a 12-hour finale for Indian Idol. You know, this is the first time Indian Idol has got a finale of 12 hours. It's starting at 12 p.m. in the afternoon, ending at 12 p.m. in the night. We have been shooting morning and night. But I got up. I slept at 6, got up at 9. And I was right there on the chair waiting for you. I said, I'm not going to ever make Cyrus Brocha wait.
My God, what are you saying? So much pressure. Now I'm feeling really bad. I just about made it on time thanks to our tech issues here.
It's fun. Anu, now, the people of India...
We can say Indian Idol is Indian IDLE because for 12 hours you have to do nothing and watch the television.
The people are going to love it. You know, this time, it's this frenzied excitement because the singers are amazing. No one knows who's going to become the Indian Idol. So people are all very excited.
Damn it, if only we could do setting and make some money on the side, yaar. Agar, sir, tere ko pata hai, toh just tell us and we'll just put some in Ladbrokes. Simple.
Ladbrokes in England, you can put. Toh kala bol rahi hai.
Kaise?
Kaise?
Kaise? Oh, right, that's right, Bumbaya. Okay, what a pleasure, Anu Malik, and everybody who's tuned in. Hope you've had a great time. Lot of love and respect. We bow to you, sir, and hope to see you again soon.
Cyrus, don't bow to me. I hug you, Cyrus. I hug all the people of India. I love my country. And I pray for the health and happiness of my great country, India, and all the people who have given me so much love along the years. Thank you so much.
All right. Cheers.
Cheers. Awesome. Cheers. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.